Hello friends, today we are going to solve another interview problem, that is print all subarrays of a given array. Okay, so problem is quite straightforward. We have given an array, right? And we have to print all the subarrays. So what is subarray? A subarray is a continuous part of array for which the length could be from 1 to the maximum size would be the array size. Okay, and don't confuse it with the subsequence. Subsequence is a part of array where the elements not necessarily can be continuous. Okay, so let's take example. If we have array, that is, let's say 1, 2, 3, so subarrays, okay, subarrays is the continuous part of that array. So that is, it could be 1, okay, it could be 1, 2, it could be 1, 2, 3, it could be 2, 3, okay, 2, 3, but it cannot be 1, 3. Okay, so 1, 3 is a subsequence. So 1, 1, 3, these are the subsequence. Okay, so let's go back to the problem. So we have given an array and we have to print all the subarrays. Okay, so so we have to print all the subarrays, okay? So there is, if we take this example, so what are the subarrays? So 1, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 2, 3, 2, and then let's drag this out, okay? And then we have 3, so 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 3, and 3. Yeah, these are the subarrays. So in this video we are going to discuss non-recursive approach, and I'll make another video where we'll solve this problem using recursion. Okay, so today we are going to do non-recursive. So 1, 2, 3, okay, so the first thing we need to fix is our starting point. Okay, so as you can see here, here's the starting point is 1. So 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so first we'll fix our starting point. So for I 0 to n, and this I is our starting point. Okay, then we'll take the size of groups. Okay, so basically the size of subarray. So first it would be size of 1, then it would be size of 2, and then it would be size of 3. So we'll have for j is equal to 1 to n. So the maximum size can be the size of array. Okay, so the size is j, and then in another for loop, k is equal to so now we'll iterate. So let's say we fix the size, we fix the starting point as 1, okay, and we fix the size as 2. So I is equal to 0, the starting point 0, and j is equal to the length. Okay, so that I fixed 2. So now I will iterate k is equal to 0 to 2, and I'll print all the elements. Okay, so we'll iterate this from I to j, and then we'll print all the elements. So first fix the starting point. So let's take another example. So once we are done with 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, then I will change to 1, right? So we'll fix the starting point here. So I is pointing here, and now my group size can be 1, so that is 2, and then group size of 2, so that is 2, 3. So in the third loop, we'll iterate from starting point to the group size and print all the possible subarrays. Okay, so let's go back to our code. Okay, so yeah, this is the same example, and we'll discuss about the recursive approach in some other video. So we use 3 nested loops. Outer loop will decide the starting point of the subarray, call it as a start point. First inner loop will decide the group size, the subarray size. The group size is starting from I and goes up to the array size. Let's call it as groups. The third inner loop actually prints subarray by iterating the given array from starting point and print the next group elements. Okay, so let's understand the code. So this is our driver function. This is a function takes input as array. So first is a starting point, right? So first loop fix the starting point. The second loop we fix the group. So group is nothing but the subarray size. Okay, so subarray size starting from 1, so starting from a starting point and then going up to the array size. And third, we are actually printing the subarray elements, so going from a starting point to the group size and print all the elements of that array, of that subarray. Okay, so let's run this code. Yeah, so we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and if we run that, yeah, so starting with 1, okay, so here the group size is 1, so 1, then group size 2, so 1, 2, group size 3, 1, 2, 3, and group size 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now the starting point changes to 2, group size 1, so 2, group size 2, 2, 2, 2, 3, group size 3, 2, 3, 4. Similarly, change the starting point to 3 and 3, 4, change the starting point to 4 and only 4. Okay, so this is how we'll solve this problem. Now we can mark this problem as completed, and visit our website totalhorizon.com for more interesting problems. We'll see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.